What's happening, everyone? This is Michael yet again, and thank you all for joining me here this evening. You know, I got to thinking, it's been quite some time since I did an episode of B-Movie Mania, and I definitely have a film that fits the build this evening. Now, this movie was directed by Shinichi Fukuzawa, and it's a movie that, you know, given the name, will throw you for a loop because it's called Bloody Muscle Bodybuilder in Hell. And this is a film that I was introduced to by a good friend here on YouTube, Ramble Raph for Life, who actually reviewed this film. And he had mentioned its similarities to Sam Raimi's Evil Dead movies. And when I heard that, I was all in because I'm a huge fan of Sam Raimi's original Evil Dead films. And any film that is similar to those films, I'm in. I had to see it. So I immediately went out and ordered this and saw it for myself. Now, what I will say is that this wasn't a very pricey DVD at all. The film hasn't been released on Blu-ray, and thus far, this is the only way to get it. I hear that there's going to be a collector's Blu-ray release of this that's supposed to be coming up, so let's hope. But what I will say about this movie is that the picture quality is really nothing to write home about. It's more or less a glorified VHS, or at the very least, a poorly put together DVD. The picture quality is not very good at all. Now, it was filmed on Super 8 film, so it does have an authentic, almost realistic look to it. But ultimately, I would say as an independent film, it looks like an amateuristic endeavor, which, you know, basically it is, because Fukuzawa directed this. He wrote this. He starred in this. It was his first film, at least I would say feature length, but the running time is only an hour, and he had done a couple of short films. So this, I would say, was his longest running film up to date when this was finally released. And by the way, this film, I would say, not only has inspiration in Sam Raimi's Evil Dead films, I would also say that it took inspiration from Peter Jackson's Brain Dead film. And also, there's a little bit of the television Incredible Hulk in here. There's a sequence where he pretty much transforms into a bodybuilder. And you see a scene where he's ripping off his shirt like Lou Ferrigno used to do. And, you know, tossing the shirt aside and all that kind of stuff. And there's also a little bit of John Carpenter's The Thing in here, and just a smidgen of one of the Hellraiser sequences that I seem to recall in this movie while I was watching it. Now, this is a very low budget film. I'm not quite sure how much it cost to make it, but it's very low budget. We have basically two locations in this. One is a park and one is the home in which all the action takes place. Which, kind of like the Evil Dead films where you have the one cabin in the woods, this is just a home also that everything takes place in. And being that Fukuzawa wrote this film, directed this film, starred as the lead character, he also did the special effects, and he did the practical effects, and he did stop motion for the film as well. Originally, he wanted to shoot this in 16mm film, but he had a problem. He did not have the funding at which to do that. So he ended up using Super 8, which, you know, given the way the film looks, the production, the Super 8 seems to lend to the authenticity of the film. So I definitely think it helps the film. The house that this was filmed in was a home that belonged to his father. And his father was actually in the process of getting rid of the house, selling it away. So he allowed his son to shoot the film in there. And another thing about this movie, too, is that one of the things about 8mm film is that once you shoot with that, you can't see what you've shot until you have the film processed and printed. So Fukuzawa had shot like 80% of the film. And when he had it processed and printed, he took a look at it and he discovered that it was really low quality. And he ended up not being able to use any of the footage that he'd shot because it was in such a poor state. So he ended up having to scrap 80% of the film and start all over. I will say that, you know, the film began production in 1995, but unfortunately, this movie would end up taking 17 years before it was completed. And much of that was due to budget. Much of that was due to arranging shooting schedules with the other two actors that he had hired. And another thing, too, is that the fact that, as I mentioned earlier, 80% of the film he had to scrap and start all over. When the film would finally be completed, it would be 2012. And also that year, it would see a very limited release in theaters in Japan. The film was successful, albeit briefly, but it was a success. And furthermore, in 2014, the film would see a VHS release and a DVD release. Now, what did I think about this movie? And I don't want to give any of it away. You have elements from Evil Dead, but at the same time, I feel like it's its own film as well. There's nothing really intricate about the story or even the characters. But one thing I will say that I thought was kind of neat about this movie was that when I watched it immediately, I was attracted to this character. I thought that this was a pretty likable character. He and his ex-girlfriend in this movie, very likable. And that was kind of strange because I really didn't expect that. You know, sometimes you watch a film and you have this, you know, being a foreign film, sometimes you have this lost in translation sort of feeling with the characters where you feel like there's a disconnect. But immediately, I really liked the lead guy. Fukasawa really did a great job playing it. And there is a lot of similarities to Sam Raimi's Evil Dead in what he wears, having the shotgun, having the effects that are just over the top, eyeballs popping out, things of that nature. So there are a lot of elements in it that are reminiscent of Sam Raimi's film. Now, granted, given the very low budget of this movie, it certainly couldn't hold a candle to Raimi's film. But on a pure visceral level and a pure creative level, it's really kind of admirable what Fukasawa was able to do with this film. It, like I said, only has an hour running time. It's really over the top. It's a lot of fun. And I think that's what I liked about it. There were laugh out loud moments while I was watching it. It's certainly not the greatest horror film that I've ever seen in terms of movies like horror and slash comedy. But at the same time, it was a fun watch. I did enjoy it. I liked the characters. It was a fun watch. And I would most certainly say if you like quirky horror films in the vein of Evil Dead, most certainly give this one a shot because it's just over the top. And the name itself, you know, Bloody Muscle Bodybuilder in Hell. Fukasawa was supposed to play this character that was really beefy, really bulky. But he discovered that, you know, given the time that it took to put this film together, he had intended to work out and really buff up. But he found that his job and life in general, he just didn't have the time to get as big as he wanted to get in this movie. So he always kind of regretted that fact that he didn't bulk up like he wanted to, hence the title Bodybuilder. But his secret strength in this film is certainly something that will surprise you. So I would say, you know, if you're in for just an hour movie, just, you know, laid back, relaxed and fun, just go for this movie, man. You know, most importantly, I would say that, you know, there's no political overtones and shit like that. It's just a movie that you just sit down, turn the brain off, enjoy and laugh for about an hour. So definitely check out Bloody Muscle Bodybuilder in Hell. This is one that when the Blu-ray comes out, I'm looking forward to getting it because I would really like to see this in really good picture quality, or at least cleaned up and much better than what it is on this Blu-ray or this DVD. Now, what I will say also is that this DVD has a few special features on it. Not anything great, but there are special features on it. And I think it was only like $6.99. So, thanks for watching, everybody. Take care of yourselves, be safe, and I'll see you in the next video.